Hey guys, this is Techno Freak here. Today I'm going to show you how to use soundboards on games like DotA 2 Counter Strike. Actually, soundboarding is really easy. You only need two softwares to do soundboarding, and then you need to change a couple of settings, and you'll be good to go. So, in order to do that, you'll first need your soundboarding software, which is I have here EXP Soundboard. The link is here. I'll put all the links in the description. So at first you have to go to the website. So when you're in the website, you have to press here to download the soundboard app. And then you have to wait a little bit and the download will start automatically. I already have it, so I will not download it. And then you will have to download another software, which is Virtual Cable. I'll explain it later what it is and what it does. Here is the link. Again, I'll put the link in the description. You have to go here. And once you are in the website, you have to scroll down and you have to click here, this download. I've already downloaded it, so they are showing me this dialog. But and after you've finished, you'll have something like this one here, the soundboard app, and this is the virtual cable driver. You don't need to install this soundboard app. You just need to double click it and it will open. So there is no need to install this app, but you need to install this virtual cable driver. So you have to right click here, extract the files, then you have to go here and install it from either of these two options. If you have a 32-bit Windows, you have to use this one, and if you have a 64-bit Windows, you have to use this one. If you're trying to use a 64-bit installer, then you have to run it as administrator. Right click and click here, and then hit install driver option. And then this window will pop up and they will say installation complete and successful. You might reboot your system to finalize the installation. But what I have seen that you don't need to look at your system for this one. So it's okay. Sorry about that. And they'll then take you to their website and say thank you, but we'll just close this one. And then we'll open the soundboard app. Don't worry, it may take some time to open the soundboard app. There it is. But first you have to select these options. In the first output, you have to select the speakers. And the second output option, you have to select cable input. And then you have to tick here. Here is the tick, and then we can add our sound clips, and there here are some sound clips, and I'll also put the link of them in the description. And let's add some sounds and let's see if they work. Okay, then select this one, and then we have to select the hotkeys. You have to left click here and then select the hotkeys. Let's select this one, Alt plus Z, and then done. And now if we press Alt plus Z,
get back.
See, now we can hear the sound. But this is not it. You have to change your Steam settings. to use them in the game. So first of all, you have to go to Steam, then click here Steam, and then go to settings. Then you have to go to voice, and here you have to change device, and then here you have to select the cable output, and then you have to set it as default device. And after you have set it as default, you press OK, and here OK, I'm finished changing settings. Then press OK. Then you have to start your game. As an example, I'm now starting DotA 2. This will also work in any game you play. Once the game has started, you have to go to settings. Then you have to press here audio. And then you have to press here open mic.
A new journey.
Then you have to put the threshold to like 5 or 0%. Now see if it works. Let's press Alt plus C.
Get back!
And there we go, now you can use it in the game. That's it. But many people face some problems while communicating with other softwares because you've set that virtual cable as default audio device. So you have to change the audio recording device for every other application that you use. For example, let's go to Discord. Once it starts, you just press your user settings, then go to voice, and change. You will see that this is set as the input device. Then you have to change it to the microphone, and it'll be good to go. And you can solve this problem for other communicating softwares like Skype too. And that's pretty much it. I hope this video helps you, and if this video helped you and you like this video, please give it a like. And if you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe. And if you have any other questions, please comment it down below. Thank you very much. I see you guys in the next video.